Now we are coming to Surah Al-Baqarah. What Surah Al-Baqarah is doing and how its relation is to Surah Al-Fatiha. As I mentioned to you, that basically religion, in religion what happening is, you've got fitrah, true nature, you got a will, irada, strong irada, which makes you to get, then seek the knowledge and then amal, do things properly. What Surah Al-Fatiha is done? Surah Al-Fatiha basically is a response of that true nature that Allah has given to you. The true nature is that you long to Allah. You want to thank the one who made all the favor upon you. And your mind helps, reason helps. So you've got fitrah, true nature, and true reasoning. These two help each other. The first word comes from your mind is what? Alhamdulillah. You see really so much favor from your Lord. How he made you, all the favors around you, water, you know, and food, and all so many things. The first thing comes to your mind is what? To thank him, Alhamdulillah. So that is what? Coming from nature. You know, like it's a natural thing. Like child, when the mother gives milk, you can see from the eye of the child, he's grateful. He thanks the mother. Thanking and gratefulness is the first thing coming from the true nature. You know, and the reasoning mocks more and more. To what Surah Fatiha has done, you know, response of the true nature. Thanking for your Lord and using right to how much of my Lord has given. And then one step further. Surah Fatiha then ask the Lord, give me more. You have given me so much, I thank you. But I want from you something more. What that more is? In Surah Al-Fatiha, you thank your Lord for what he has given you. And use your mind properly to how to thank him. But your mind taught you, you know, my Lord gave me so much and I thank him, but I need something more. What that something more is in Surah Al-Fatiha? That something more is, you ask, oh my Lord, you gave me everything which I need really, but tell me how to use it and how to live here. Tell me how to worship. I want to worship. I want just to obey you. I just want to, you know, in your service. But I don't know how to do. I don't know how to worship you. Oh my Lord, as you've given, done all favor upon me, do this favor. That's why you said in Surah Al-Fatiha, اِهْدِنَا الصِّرَاطَ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ. Oh my Lord, guide me. Everything you have given. And that actually Quran mentions so many surahs all the time. That among the favors of Allah, as he created you, made you, also he guided you. Quran says, أَلَمْ نَجْعَلْ لَهُ عَيْنَيْنِ وَلِسَانَ وَشَفَتَيْنِ وَهَدَيْنَاهُ النَّجْدَيْنِ. Didn't I make for human being two eyes? Didn't I, you know, make him this and this, lifts, all those things? Then didn't I guide him? Guidance is his biggest favor after all this favor, after natural favors, your mind, all those things. Then the next favor is guidance. That favor also Quran mentions Surah Al-A'la, Alladhi khalaqa fasawwa, walladhi qaddara fahada. He guidance is one of the favor of his Lord. But that comes once you realize all favor, then you ask him. That what happened to the Prophet Muhammad. He realized Allah's favor. He comes to the cave of Hira. He thanks him. Oh my Lord, you have given me too much, so much. But now I want to worship you, but I don't know how to worship. Tell me. To what Quran said, وَوَجَدَكَ ضَالًا فَهَدَى. Allah found you that you did not know how to worship. Then he taught you how to worship. He guided you. You see, guidance basically comes when you are thirsty. When you're thirsty, then guidance can work. That's what people don't realize. People think when Quran is there, why people are not guided? So many people think because they don't have enough proof. To prove that Quran is the book of Allah, they'll be guided. No. This is the mistake really. It is not that Quran is the book of Allah, then people will guide. The problem really is another problem. Problem is people are not thirsty. If the water is there and people don't feel thirst, whatever you proof you bring, they're not going to drink the water. You need to raise the thirst in their heart. That's what you need really. If you don't, they're not thirsty, nothing will happen. That's what people need really. When people don't want to worship Allah, you have to raise this longing. When the longing comes, they will look for guidance. So for example, if you want to travel, if I tell you roads of my village, that in my village there are this road and that road and this thing to see and all those things, you will be tired, bored. Why you want to know, I have to know about your village? But somehow, you want to go and see this for a reason. Now yeah, the reason for you to go there. Now you will make every effort to find out the way for my village. Any information to can help you to reach there, it will be good for you. You're looking for that. The way is when people feel need for something, urge for something, then it is easy for them to learn. That what actually Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha makes an urge in your heart for the guidance. And Surah Al-Baqarah comes to fulfill that urge. So you said, oh Allah, ihdina, guide me. The Quran comes, okay, dhalikal kitab la raifi hudan. Guidance has come. You wanted guidance, now I get the guidance. So this guidance only can work for the people who want the guidance. Who's, if you say, ihdina salat al-mustaqim, then you get a guidance. If you don't want guidance, even if it is there, it is not going to benefit you. To try to understand properly, that why the way of the messenger prophet never has been to prove anything. The way has been to raise the thirst in your heart. You start longing for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Once that thirst comes, you're desperate to learn. Like you'll see, there are many, many people in this country, now they want to learn Islam, Arabic language. We did not come and tell them, now you must learn Arabic language. Meaning is, for some reason, they got a thirst, they want to know about the Lord, their religion. Now, they are looking for all possibilities. They go for every direction to learn Arabic language. Because they have got a need, urge in their heart. That was Surah Al-Fatiha. Surah Al-Fatiha basically raises your nature properly, makes you to have this urge for worship and obedience for Allah. Then Surah Al-Baqarah comes to respond to that. Now you want guidance, and that actually also in Surah Al-Baqarah does guidance, that also what Allah said from very beginning. When Allah created Adam alayhi salam, and there was really, you know, rehearsal, you know, in paradise, Allah said to Adam, do this and don't do this, something like that. And Adam, you know, disobeyed. Then after that, he repented and Allah forgave him. Then Allah said to Adam, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى. Surah Al-Baqarah. Now after that, what will happen is, you will go to earth. Now your children, all the time, they will keep receiving guidance from me. If they follow, they will come to paradise. So this guidance will keep coming. But the guidance only help people when the people have got an urge for the guidance. So if people don't want to follow the Quran, the way is not to prove the word Quran is. The way is first to create this urge in their heart. Make them to realize that they need really to worship their Lord. So for example, if somebody is not healthy, for example, somebody is smoking, and so much, you know, smoking, and you want to ask him to leave smoking, and then you bring to a doctor and said, this doctor is qualified, a great doctor, and this and that, and all those things you prove. Nothing will happen. Because this person does not feel any urge to leave smoking. So whatever doctor brings, it is irrelevant to him. But what you need to release, first to prove him, first to actually explain to him properly that how much damage his life is doing by smoking. How harm it is. Once this harm of smoking becomes deeper in his mind, he really starts thinking that how much harm. Then he himself will say, okay, I really, you know, I did not know there's so much harm, and now I really see. What is the cure? He will be mad to find a cure. He will be looking for the cure everywhere. Once you know, if somebody said to me that, you know, you have developed a cancer in your body, you know, once I realize, even if the person is not a very great expert, it will make me mad. I will go to every possible direction to find out if you have this illness or not. And if I have, what cure is there? So this is actually what Quran does. Quran actually is quenching the thirst of the people who realize they are thirsty. If people somehow deceive they are not thirsty, Quran will not benefit them. First thing is to raise this urge in their, make this thirst in the heart of the people. First you feel hungry, then any food. But if something you don't feel need, nothing can help you. Is it clear? To understand, that's why Surah Al-Fatiha is very important. Surah Al-Fatiha, what does? It responds to the nature properly. It makes mind to function properly. And then mind asks you, now I have done thanks for my Lord, but I want really to listen to him. Because so loving Lord loves me so much. You know, how can I live in this life if I don't please him? I should learn how to please him. You know, I cannot afford not to please him. It will be harmful to me to make him angry. I want to learn how to please him. And I want to learn what can make him angry. So I don't do those things. You become, you know, just basically all the time think about that. And also, really without him worship, you feel something missing. I tell you, really, children, small children, where they depend on their mother. When the mother is there, you can see they're playing so nicely to their heart, everything. They enjoy the toys, they talk with you and all those things. So they do. But as soon as the mother leaves, what happens? Then they basically, all those things that have been, you think, you know, the child is so much busy with the toys, you know, and all that, he does not need a mother. As soon as the mother goes, all those things have been meaningless to him. He runs up after her. He makes noise. He cries. It took presence of the mother made him to enjoy everything. When mother is gone, nothing has interest. No enjoyment in the life. Without the mother, nothing is there. When a mother is there, everything has sense to him. He can talk to you, he can play everything, he can run, he can do. But when a mother leaves, that every sense become nothing. He cries. Don't you know this? Doesn't everybody see this? This really what should be happened for everybody, for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When Allah is not in my heart, really, nothing makes sense. Eating does not make sense. Drinking does not make sense for me. Nothing makes sense. When Allah is there, then everything makes sense. Without Allah, if I don't worship Him, I miss it so much. For a child, really, his mom is much, much more than anything else. And you can't say, really, ask a child, you know, I take your mom and I give you, you know, all this money, millions of pounds, is going to help me? Tell a child, I'll take your mom from you and give you a palace. I'm going to make you the queen, you know, king of this country, a queen of the country. Not going to, nothing. Without him, if he has a mother, then everything can make sense. You can say, okay, give me more money, but my mom is there. If mother is not there, nothing can make him happy. That actually how human nature is, but nature has been corrupted. For the believers, without Allah, nothing makes sense. Nothing makes him happy. But if Allah is there, then everything is there. Then everything makes sense. Without Allah, nothing makes sense. So, you know, that keep understanding the relation between Fatiha and Surah Al-Baqarah. The Fatiha basically is the response of the true nature in the human being. And then reasoning, which basically is based on that true nature. This reasoning makes you to make more thanks and also tells you, oh, it's my Lord who does so much for me. Let me know what can make him happy so I can get more from him. I can become nearer to him. So then you ask him, oh, my Lord, guide me. Tell me what can make you happy. I do that. What can make you angry? I don't do that. You ask him, God, Ehdina, guide me, right path of the. Then he says, okay, I'm revealing this. So this revelation came. But when this revelation came, again, this has two conditions. You read the revelation and use the mind. Because this revelation will not have meaning without understanding. Either nature has no meaning without reasoning. Nature only can make full sense when you use your mind. Because mind is a helper. Reason is a helper. Reason helps nature, and reason also helps of your understanding of the revelation. Revelation without reason is not going to benefit you. Never can benefit you. That was Surah Al-Baqarah really is a surah of thinking.